sexy Dexter fans. So, spoiler alert, in case my tears are not evidence of things that happened in the episode, okay, so I literally have been crying for the past, like, about 40 minutes. I literally started crying at, like, 9:20 in the episode. And let me explain. Just... So, if you want... If you're coming here to watch, like, a fully fleshed out review, an analysis of the entire season and story until now, I can't give you very much because I literally hurt so freaking bad. And I feel perfectly paralyzed right now. God, that was literally the most painful episode that they could have left us with. I mean, I thought, you know, everyone would think that the most painful thing that they could do would be to, God, I don't even know if the camera is looking at me. I don't know. You don't really want to. But, I mean, everyone would think that, like, Dexter dying or something would be the absolute worst. And for me, it was always, from the very beginning of this season, the absolute worst thing that they could do would be to hurt Deborah. And that they did in the worst way. I mean, I thought, sure, maybe she would die, but the fact that Dexter had to do it himself. I knew from like halfway in the episode and they were gonna kill her. I knew it. As soon as they said, you know, it was so stupid because the doctor, like, I'm sorry, I am really not, I should not be talking right now. You should have heard me talking to my family after the episode. And everyone was laughing at me too, so don't even, I see you. My voice, I don't know what he was saying. The doctor's like, oh, I'm optimistic, and then all of a sudden she's freaking, well, this horrible, devastating loss of oxygen to her brain, and she's going to be brain dead for the rest of her life. And I'm just like, no, Deborah is the one person who's supposed to be happy. And when she's talking to him in the hospital bed, and like when she's in the room with him and he's like, you're just supposed to be happy. And so I was like, no, shut up. You know, he's not supposed to be happy. You are supposed to be happy. This was all his freaking fault. And I mean, it's like he sees that, but it's like, I mean, what would he, I mean, it kind of reminded me, I guess, of what's her name? Camilla? Was that her name? The old friend of Harry's who knew about Dexter from the beginning, the key lime pie. It kind of reminded me of that, except this was, like, amplified in the freaking extreme sense. And I'm still literally in shock. Like, I had a bad feeling, too, from, like, they were showing all the flashbacks and just how incandescently happy Deborah is and how grateful she is to be alive and that Dexter's a son and he's the best brother in the world. And I knew that I knew that they were setting us up for some horrible freaking tragedy with Deborah. And they carried it through, alright. I mean, I wanted, like, I was like, Dexter, if you don't freaking, like, I was literally, I don't know if I was the only one, but I was like, Dexter, you need to kill yourself. Like, you just freaking killed your sister. I mean, maybe arguably you could say that the life that she wanted to have was lost and she'd never be able to be happy, but you killed her. And it's like, I love you, Dev, and I'm like, shut up. I don't want to deal with any of this. I was just puking, like, you should have seen me. I thought about filming my reaction to the episode, but I was like, no, I wanted to fully be immersed in it, and then I was, because if I wasn't, I probably would, I don't know. But, like, a lot of people tweeted me earlier, and they were like, ugh, that was the most intense. And then a few people who I really respect and admire, and, you know, our opinions often correlate together, were like, yeah, so this was the worst ending of all time. And in terms of pain, that was the freaking worst thing that they ever could have done. And now I see exactly what they were saying when they were like, well, it feels right to us, but some people are gonna be hated. I mean, maybe looking back, all people do. I don't know. All I know is that Deborah is the one person who deserved to get out happy. And she's fucking cool. I'm so sorry, but I can't do this. She was the one character. I saw so much of myself in her. And I was like, I feel like I lost someone, you know? I have literally never had this emotional of a response, like, to anything on TV ever. Ever. And I knew, like, I don't know. I didn't want her to die. She didn't deserve it. I'm sorry. Isn't this fun? Isn't this the most informative, reflective vlog in the world? I think so. I have an essay that's due tonight at midnight, and I'm just gonna write my professor and say, dear professor, one of my best friends died and I'm going to be gone from school for a very long time. And then maybe she'll email me back and be like, hey, one of my best friends died too, I'll see you at the funeral, lol, I wasn't gonna grade your paper anyway. And then we'll just have a moment together. But fuck, I didn't see that coming. You know what I wanted? I wanted to see Dexter found out by Miami Metro once and for all. And I mean, it's like, I guess in a way he gives himself justice in making, like, Deborah his last victim, you know? And like, when he takes her, I'm like laughing at myself because I know it's so ridiculous, but I can't help it. He takes her out and she's covered in white. And it reminds me of, like, when he got married to Rita and just, like, the innocence, and he drops her away. I mean, emotions aside, there was a lot of really implausible things that happened in this episode, like, a lot. I mean, it still bothered me just how, like, people like Saxon and Hannah McKay are running around just freaking, you know, they haven't changed a hair on their head since, you know, they've been all over the news and all that crap. Like, it's like, what? How? But, I mean, that aside, like, just all the ridiculous things in this totally nincompoop doctor who's like, hey, it's all good, just kidding. All that aside, like, I feel rocked, and not in a good way. I mean, there was no way that Dexter could have survived that hurricane. I mean, maybe the writers are trying to make it so that there is room for a spinoff or something, or like a sequel series, but I don't even, I can't. It's just, it's crazy to me how everything starts in the vibrant, beautiful Miami. And then it goes to like freaking Oregon. He's a lumberjack. This is like where I live. So maybe I should be happy because now I'm closer to Dexter. But I mostly want to kick him in the face for ruining his sister's life. And I mean, he says like at the doctors that you know, he's never seen a miracle. When they're saying like it would take a miracle for her to recover. And he's like, I've never seen a miracle. So maybe that for him is like, I'm not gonna chance it. I'm not gonna risk seeing Deborah never get to be who she truly is ever again. And I mean, it's like mercy killing, I guess, but she didn't deserve that. And she deserved a chance, I think. And I don't know how I feel about it all. Like, I... And then Hannah raising Harrison, like, I mean, the whole scene, like when Dexter's like saying goodbye to them and how it almost kind of feels final, sort of reminds me of season 4, like with Trinity and everything, and Dexter's trying to get Rita and the kids safe to the Keys, and he's gonna meet her there and all of that. Like, I don't know, the fact that Hannah lived was surprising. But I think it's appropriate that her and Dexter didn't get to share that Argentina dream. And I, in like seeing that news story, you know, on her little tablet and just kind of realizing like, I don't know, everything just feels so surreal. And the fact that Miami Metro doesn't know, and like, and how all the little side plots and things that happened throughout the season just sort of got lost in the end. I mean, I think they had to make up so much in terms of, like, emotional intensity in this episode. Because, like, honestly, the last few episodes, I really didn't feel attached to. Because I was just so disoriented with what was going on. So, I mean, it's like, if their goal was to, like, leave me dry heaving up my metaphorical air guts, then good, you done your job. But did I like the ending? No, because my absolute freaking favorite character in the universe is gone, and it's like I feel it in every part of my being. And if I don't graduate because I fail this class, because I fail this essay that's due at midnight tonight because of my state of emotional compromise, then I am going to send Showtime a letter and make sure that they give me a diploma in dedication to their stupid series that has totally wrecked my existence. I mean, maybe that'll get me a job somewhere. Well, they'll hire me to be a showrunner so I can make shows that will hurt you in a good way. That's what I'm gonna do. Because everything sucks right now. See my beautiful season 1 poster that I got? It was so wonderful, and I wanna like celebrate it. Right now, I mostly just want to go 6 feet under. I mean, I don't know. I feel like soon I'm going to have to sit back and rethink about and reprocess everything, and then I'll make another vlog, like kind of looking at the scope of the season. But I mean, I think the whole thing is like, it's all Dexter's fault, and even when he tries to do the right thing, like, it's too late. And I don't know, I just truly feel blown away, and it's absolutely sick, because nope, nothing is okay. I mean, I guess like the parallelism between like the first season and this season is kind of crazy. Like, you know, he kills his own brother for Deborah, and then he ends up having to put her down in the end because of everything. It's just, in this finale, I'd hope to see, I'd really hope to see like, you know, other characters in Dexter's psyche, like Rita or Dokes or Trinity or even his brother again, you know, to see like other forces. But it was very Dexter and Deborah centric, but in a way that is like literally making my insides want to crawl out of my esophagus and run to the nearest train track and just peace out, because I can't stomach anything anymore. I never imagined it was gonna hurt this much, you know? Because I guess I'd always felt that the Dexter, you know, that there was gonna be that justice factor, and that the people who've known him all along would see who he really was. Like, and after the way that he killed Saxon and everything, and the way that Quinn and Batista were like, yeah, self-defense, ... And, yeah, I think that the way that they were so emotionally involved with Deborah kind of clouded their view as well, you know? And that they weren't in a place of being willing to believe that Dexter could be anything more than what he was in that moment, which was vindictive, against this, butt wipe who freaking destroyed his universe. And yet it's the whole irony thing, because Dexter let that happen, and it's the whole thing like Hannah McKay and Argentina and and it was, honestly, if Hannah McKay had never come back, I think it's distinctly possible that Deborah would still be alive. Because it's the fact that Hannah McKay came back that made Dexter start thinking like, well, maybe I don't want to be a killer. Maybe I want to like go start over, you know, instead of like taking care of, I don't know. Maybe I just like Dexter being a killer. But except not in the way that he was in this endgame. Oh my god. It's raining so hard out right now. It just feels appropriate for the mood. But just, I don't know. I don't know that I feel like everything is resolved. And there's just so many, like, why? Hurts a lot, and again, I'll make another vlog soon when I'm not like in a state of just complete turmoil. I feel abused and ripped apart. I don't even know. There's so much I could say, so much that I could pick apart. I'll do it all later. As for right now, I need to like just go jump off a cliff and then magically survive and wind up in the cold northwest chopping down trees. And, you know, somehow. I never imagined it would have ended like this. They should have called this episode, "This is the way the world ends," you know? I love Dexter forever and always, and I was looking forward to getting to like restart the series and rewatch everything, but like, it's gonna take a while. I need to heal, I need to process, I need to, I don't know, go cry a little more in my solitude, because the people that I watched the episode with were so mean to me. But yeah. What did you guys think? I mean, I'm here for you. It's gonna be okay. Let's just pretend that this season is just where everything left off, and there's like a big parade, and Dex, like, and just go back in time, and that's all. That's all I need. I need a drink. I love you guys so much, and I look forward to emotionally vomiting with you all. We'll just go to the bathroom together and, you know, we'll just cry our tears straight into the sink, and I'll dry yours, you dry mine. we'll deal with it all together. Yeah, so the bottom line is, no, Emily does not like this, because freaking Deborah Morgan is the goddess of all, and I love her a lot. And Jennifer Carpenter, I'll go find Jennifer Carpenter, and I will go sit in her lap and weep, because this is what he's done to me, and this is what Showtime did to her. Sorry if my hair is bugging you. I don't know. I have nothing left inside of me. I officially feel empty. Now, see, the sequel is going to be when I become a psychopath, because this traumatic experience drained me of all life, so I'm going to become a monster now. And that's... I see what you did there, Showtime. It was a conspiracy. They're raising up a generation of psychopaths by ripping their hearts out. I feel like watching that episode, I was in that shipping container. You know? That's what I feel like. And that sucks. Well, I'm gonna go die a little more. I don't even remember if I pushed the record button on my camera, so I'm gonna like laugh if none of this recorded. So. My thoughts to be continued. You guys are amazing. We'll get through this together, I think, maybe. We'll see. Unless Dexter pulls a freaking plug on us. Who knows? Can't trust nobody. Alrighty. I'll see you guys later. I promise I'll be a little better next time, but at the same time, I can't promise, so. Ah! Alright guys, take care, and yep, good night, goodbye, I love you, it's gonna be okay, mwah. You're still sexy, we're still sexy, I know we are, alright.